Hello dear students, welcome back to the lecture series of Advanced Java. Today we are going to learn something about Request Dispatcher interface. We are going to look at the interface in detail as well as we are going to move on to practical implementation of Request Dispatcher. So without wasting any time, let's begin. First let me introduce to you the concept of Request Dispatcher or what this Request Dispatcher actually does. Now the main use or function of this request dispatcher is it helps you to transfer your request and response, or in other words you can say it helps you to call one servlet from another servlet. Okay, now there may be cases when you need to bifurcate your data into two or three different paths and all these paths need to be handled individually or differently. In that case, let us take a very simple example where you are supposed to log in. Now, when you are logged in, you are having a different page. When you are validating, you have a different page which is validating your username, your password, your credentials. And your third page will be your welcome page, which is actually welcoming you onto your website. So, all these things can be handled via different servlets. And we may need to call one servlet from another servlet. This is where your request dispatcher will come to your help. Now this request dispatcher interface helps you with two basic things. One is it helps you to transfer this request response from one servlet to another servlet, and also it may help you to bring back response from a certain servlet back to its own servlet. So it is doing two kinds of things. The first thing is it provides environment to forward the request from current servlet to another servlet, and second thing it helps you to include whatever is there in a target resource or target servlet into the current servlet. Okay, now this is not just limited to servlets. You can send or dispatch requests, or you can transfer requests to not only servlets but to also JSP files, to HTML files, etc. So request dispatcher is not just limited to servlets. You can do the same thing for JSP files as well as for HTML files. So let us first see how this request is forwarded and how this request is included via the request dispatcher. Okay, now this is the diagrammatical flow of how requests are forwarded to different servlets or different JSP files or different HTML files. Say for example you have a client and a server. Your client is nothing but your web browser, that is your end user. Now this server will have a servlet which the client needs to call. So the client is going to simply give an HTTP request and the servlet is going to give an HTTP response. So whatever happens here is whatever data the client is going to give to the servlet will be in form of request 1, and whatever the response that it is getting back from the servlet is in form of response 2. So sending is request 1 and getting back the result is response 1 because it is coming from servlet number 1. Now this is a usual scenario which we were doing or we were implementing till now. But now there is a different scenario. Your servlet 1 is not going to do all the work for you. The final result is going to be handled by someone called as S2. Okay, so here your S1 needs to call or take help of your S2 indirectly. Okay, now this backend thing is not known by the client. The client will always look forward to S1 only. The client will think that things are coming from S1. But at the back end, your S1 is going to make use of S2. Now, how this thing is done? The browser is going to send a request to S1 in form of request 1, and the response that is to be generated by S1 is not yet submitted back to the browser. Now, this request and response are forwarded from S1 to S2. So what things are forwarded to S2? Again, request 1 and response 1. That is, whatever the client had sent, those things are forwarded to the second servlet. The second servlet is going to do the processing that it needs, and it is going to send the response back to the browser. And the response that this S2 is sending is in form of response 1 and not a new response. Okay, so this response 1 that you can see here is a part of this response. Okay, so the browser will not come to know that things are coming from S2, but it will think that things are still coming from S1. Okay, we will see this properly when we are doing a practical example of how you can forward requests using Dispatcher. Okay, this was about forwarding the request. Okay, so forwarding, you are having your results directly coming from S2, but the URL displayed is of S1. Okay, now second thing is how you are including other requests. Okay, so this including request can be done in this particular manner. Again, you have your browser or your end user, your server. On your server, you are having a servlet. Your browser is going to send a request. Ideally, S1 should give a response, but in this case, your S1 is not able to handle things alone. Therefore, you have something called as S2, which is going to complete your task. Now, S1 is going to forward request 1 and response 1 to S1. Now lies the difference between how you are forwarding requests and how you are including requests. Okay, in this S2, your S2 is going to perform all the tasks and it is going to submit it to S1. So whatever result S1 was going to give to the browser, along with that result, S2's result will be appended, and this response 1 will be given back to the browser or the client. I shall repeat myself again. Browser is sending a request to first servlet. First servlet is relaying the request to the second servlet via Tomcat. Next is your S2 is generating response. S1 is also generating its own response. S1 is appending the response of S2 inside it, and the new response is now sent back to the client. So this is how your include method will work. Include says that S1 is returning the result along with the result given from S2. So it is including the result of the other servlet into itself, therefore include. Okay, and forward is totally different. The servlet S1 is giving the response back via its URL, but the result given is that by S2 servlet and not by S1. Okay. So this is the basic difference between how a request dispatcher can forward a request and include a request. Let us see how you are going to implement with the help of request dispatcher. What rather we are going to do in the whole programmatical section. So the first thing that you are going to do is you are going to generate or create a form which is accepting the username and password. After creating this form, you will redirect the values or the fields that are taken from the form to a validator servlet. Now, this validator servlet is going to validate the credentials or the username password that are given by the client. If they are correct, then the validator's function is over and it will redirect this authenticated request to a new servlet or a second servlet, that is welcome servlet. Okay, now if it is unauthenticated, then this particular request will be handed over back to the login form or the login page or the form page. Let us see diagrammatically what we are going to do. Your web browser is running and your index.html form will be run. Okay, from this we are going to take the username password and redirect it to S1, that is your validator servlet. This validator servlet will validate the login credentials that you have sent via the form. If they are okay, then you will move on to a welcome page that you can see, that is handled by your welcome servlet. Okay, now if you are using the forward method, you can forward this request here. Okay, second thing is, if at any case my things are not as I wanted, it is not a valid user, in that case I'm going to include this index form back here as your second, as a part of your second servlet. Okay, and this form will be included in this particular validator servlet and returned back to the browser. So we are going to see forward method and include method of request dispatcher in the following program. So let's begin. Welcome to the programming session of request dispatcher. We are going to create a login form in which you are going to give the username and password. You are going to create two servlets. One is a validator servlet and one is a display or a welcome servlet. And we are going to request forward and request include using a request dispatcher. So let's begin. This is my index.html, which is a form. Okay, this form includes your input type text with name, username and password and a submit button. Okay, let us take the method post this time. Let us do these things using post. Okay, now this is my default package. I need to create two servlets because I'm going to call one servlet from another servlet. One is a validator servlet. I will add it to web.xml and I'll finish. And here let me write validator. Okay, I'll create a second servlet and I will name it welcome page, and next I will add it and I will finish it. Again, I will copy paste my code and I'll write welcome page. Okay, this is my validator and welcome page. Now this form, let us see the entries are there in web.xml. Yes. Okay, now this form is going to be redirected to the validator page. Okay, now when I will submit this form, these values are going to go to the validator. So in my validator I have to write my do post method. Okay, not get but post. Okay, because I have written post here. Okay, if it is get I have to write get here, if it is post I have to write post. Okay, now what will I do? I'm going to take the parameters that the client is entering from the form into this servlet. Okay, so these things are passed in the request object created by Tomcat. So we will directly write request dot get parameter, and inside that I will write username, and I will store it in a string because by default it returns a string username. Okay, and string password is equal to request dot get parameter, and inside that pwd. Okay, now if username dot equals, if username is admin and password dot equals admin at the rate 123, then it is a valid user, else it is not a valid user. If it is a valid user, he should be redirected to the welcome page. So let us first say that he is a valid user. So we will request dot get request dispatcher. Okay, so this get request dispatcher is a method of req, that is http servlet request object. And it returns what? It returns request dispatcher object. Okay, so when I call this method, I have to store it in a request dispatcher object, say rd. Okay, and where I want to dispatch or where I want to transfer my request, dispatcher means transferring. So where I'm going to transfer my request, so I want to transfer it onto welcome page. So I will write welcome page or the path where I want to redirect my request. Okay, now this redirect should be either forward or should be include. So what I want to do is I want to forward my request to that page. So rd.forward, and inside that I'm sending my request and response parameters as we had shown in the presentation PPT slides. Okay, so we are forwarding the request and response objects there. Why we are doing this forward? So that we can get all the parameters that the client had sent. Just have a look at the flow. This part using the post method comes here. Okay, here we were able to access all the parameters that the client had sent using request.getParameter. Now this request is used here, and this request we are forwarding onto the next page, that is this page. So whatever data the client had sent is also accessible on the welcome page also due to forwarding the request. Okay, so this I have forwarded. Otherwise what I want to do, I want to include the HTML page here. So request dispatcher rd is equal to request dot get request dispatcher, and inside this I'm going to write index dot html file. So I want to include this page now. Okay, so rd dot include request response. Okay, so in case it's not a valid user, then onto this URL, onto validator's URL, I will be able to append my this page. Okay, so my index.html page will be appended on a page with URL of validator. This we will see practically when we will run this code. Okay, now let us move on to the welcome page. This is the page. Okay, now this is a post method, and you are forwarding your request response, so this also has to be a post method. Okay, now we can do the same thing, request dot get parameter, and inside I can pass username. Okay, and I can directly write out dot println welcome and whatever the name of the user is. Okay, so it will be welcome admin in our case. Okay, let us just run the code. First I will run this code. It is going to move to validator. Validator is going to check these two credentials, and based on that it will decide whether he has to forward the request here or include the index page on this validator URL. Okay, let me write admin and admin at the rate 123. Let me submit. Okay, it is welcome admin. So first case that I gave was of a valid user. So if my user is valid, I will redirect it to welcome page. So it will go here and it is going to print admin. Okay, so whatever the client had sent is accessible from servlet 1 inside servlet 2. Okay, now just have a look at the URL. The URL is validator. Okay, so the client is just in a view, or just in a conception that things are coming from the validator servlet only. It is not aware of any welcome servlet. Okay, now let us try to include things by giving the wrong username password. Let me write admin and admin here and submit. See, again it is validator and it is including the response here. So whatever response validator was going to give, inside that the validator is appending the include request of the index.html page. Okay, so this was an example of include. This is what your forward and include method does in a request dispatcher. That's all for today. Thank you.